Hey, hello, Ruud here, with a quick update from my tiny shared workspace. Because it's exactly 1 year ago that I ordered my way too big planer for this tiny workshop. And I built my own overhead dust separator for it. Because commercial systems were way too big, or I hadn't the money to buy them. I completely redesigned the centrifugal dust separator made by Filsing Guitars. Made it more efficient and added some cyclonic inlets to it so it eliminates the need of the Y pieces and a 90 degree bend for the flex hose to go to the planer. I also added Festool waste bins with the T-lock design so it is easy to remove, and when the dust bins are removed it is overhead so I can walk under it when it's needed. In September, I designed the new inlets, based on a tip of Michiel Feist, aiming to optimize the first stage and prevent clogging at high feed rates. I even made a short video about it and shared the beta files with my Patreon supporters. Since then, we've tested the new inlets with the planer and two motors active on the cam vac. Initially, I was concerned that the height difference might be too much resistance for just two motors. But the results exceeded my expectations and the flex hose remained clean during planing. The separation in the first stage performed exceptionally well, effectively capturing most of the dust. As a design perspective, the bins could have been positioned slightly further to the left to provide more clearance to the Y piece and allowing the bin to fill more evenly. So last week we used it a lot and we ran 250 meters of floorboards through it and collected 6 large garbage bags of sawdust. And in the meantime we did not change the cam vac. So I'm very curious how much dust is inside of the cam vac. So let's find out. A large amount of particulate matter has adhered to the filter bag. It is the very fine dust that was not filtered out by the second stage and may have needed the third stage that we tested in the previous video. There is a small layer of dust inside of the barrel, including a few larger scrapes that probably happened when we forgot to empty the first bin on time and overflow to the second stage. I'm really pleased with the result so far. And for me, it's already a big game changer in this workshop. And I'd like to do some more updates and tests on it for the next year. Only for this year, this was it. And I hope that I have shown you the setup more in detail instead of in my studio. So for now, all of you have a really good new year. And a happy Christmas. And I hope to see you in the next year. Adieu!